Before we start this video, I want to give a quick shout out to our sponsor, Quid. Quid is an awesome new app where you can open packs of stickers, gifts, cards, and 3D figures all for free right on your phone. It's just been blowing up like crazy. They've got Game of Thrones, Rick and Morty, Adventure Time, Steven Universe, Five Nights at Freddy's, Bob's Burgers, and they just launched a new Marvel section. They've got a little bit of everything for everybody. It's super fun. Here I am opening some more Steven Universe packs here. This is like me, how I avoid my problems, yeah. And this is me trying to explain to everybody why I was avoiding my problems. It's just like real life. They have some super rare ones, they have some not so rare ones, and if you have some that you want to give away, or if you have some that you really want but you don't have that someone else has, you can trade with other people. And if you want to trade with us, hit us up right there, Cartoon Universe, that's our username. Me and Haley use this app. So if you want to trade, you want to get some good Steven Universe goodness or other goodness, you know, we're diverse around here, definitely hit us up, Cartoon Universe. You can even drag and drop these stickers onto iMessage just like that. Little random thing. My friend was caught quite off guard with this. And here's our profile with this random assortment of stuff on our showcase that I did for that one promotion that I never changed. It makes no sense, but luckily I can change it anytime. There it is. There's a picture from my camera roll and I could just slide right there. There's Mayor Dewey. I am having a nice little debate with him on the Charlie Brown wall. I think he's not doing so well. And the cool thing is there are new stickers, gifts, cards, and figures you can collect for free every single day. So you can always check this app. There's always new stuff. And if you want to hit the top of the leaderboards, boy, definitely check it as often as you can. There's always new packs and a lot of the good stuff sells out really quick. And if you're worried about the coins and all the stuff costing a lot of coins, look at that. You get free coins all the time, every single day. Just constantly raining that paper. So definitely go check it out. Quid, links in the description below if you want to go download it. Trade with me and Haley. It's a good time. And now, here comes the video. What is going on, guys? This is Michael Williams from Cartoon Universe. And yeah, this is different. You're not tripping. This is a completely different environment that's happening right here. So I just came into a new PC, if you didn't know, pretty recently. I got a new webcam, as you can see. And I kind of want to experiment with some new styles, new formats for these types of discussions. And it just, I don't know, I just want to engage with you guys more. It feels like this is more interesting. And honestly, it would probably be more fun to edit than just splicing together a bunch of pictures. And it's probably just more interesting for you to watch than me just splicing together a bunch of images and listening to mine or Haley's disembodied voices. So I figured this might be fun. If Haley were here, she'd be like down below me in the webcam, her own webcam or something like that, potentially. And we just have a discussion like that. So it's just more one-on-one. You know, it's more personal, it's more intimate. So let us know what you guys think about this format down below. We might stick with this, we might not, kind of depends. But yeah, I'm digging it so far. I did some test runs real fast. I'm kind of liking it. It's kind of more free form. I could do all this stuff. I could play it. I could drag all this. It's just fun. It's a good time. It's a perfect frame to stop on. So yeah, that's what it is. So let us know if you like this thing or not. If you don't want to see my face, that's all good too. I won't take it personally, I swear. All right. So anyway, on to the topic at hand, which is of course Pink Diamond. What is popping with Pink Diamond? Of course, that is the discussion that all Steven Universe videos are going to be until the end of the series at this point. No, I'm just kidding. But no, there's still a lot to talk about from Jungle Moon. We got that very interesting flashback. And there's a lot of stuff that's resurfacing that we talked about before. We talked about the potential of Pink Diamond being Rose again. I know, crazy. We didn't think that was gonna happen. We kind of threw that away after the whole Pink Diamond situation happened and the Rose shattered Pink Diamond situation, but kind of came back into fruition once again after the Jungle Moon flashback. And we also talked about the potential of Pink Diamond shattering herself. If you didn't see those videos, we'll leave a link to them in the description, or at the end of the video, I apologize, if you didn't check that out. But finish this video first, okay? So anyway, we want to bring back the possibility that the diamonds may have conspired to, or one of the diamonds, or two of the diamonds, some of the diamonds, some unknown number of the diamonds may have conspired against Pink Diamond to have her shattered and make this whole grandiose cover-up. Obviously, in the trial, it was heavily implied by the Zircon that this was a complete cover-up. And I think there's a lot of evidence in Jungle Moon that kind of leads me to believe that there may have been some genuine motivation. So as we see, Pink Diamond is not the character that we thought she was going to be. She is a complete and utter brat. She acts like a child the whole entire time. It's just a complete mess. She's just messing everything up. She's just not carrying herself like the diamonds that we've seen so far. She's not carrying herself like Yellow Diamond. She's not carrying herself like Blue Diamond. We still haven't seen White Diamond. Give it a year. We'll see White Diamond. But she's a complete another brat. She's completely out of control. She has a temper tantrum at the end of this scene. She shatters a mirror. She's out here vandalizing the diamond base property. All right, that's not how a diamond acts. And look at her. Look how small she is to the other diamonds. How is she that small? That's a whole nother video for another day. But I think there's some motivation here. And if you look at how Yellow Diamond is just pissed, she's heated. She's not feeling this. So what gives? What motivation would the diamonds have? Is this enough to warrant killing your own sister, one of your own, someone you apparently care about? Quote unquote, we don't know the extent. It looks like Blue Diamond really did genuinely care about her. She still is really mourning. So whatever's happening here, I don't think Blue Diamond is connected at all. It could be a red herring, but the fact that Blue Diamond specifically went to Pink Diamond's palanquin on Earth by herself, she wasn't showing it up for the other diamonds or anything. She wasn't trying to psych anyone out. She went there for her own personal reasons. So I doubt that she's involved in this cover-up, if there even is a cover-up. So why would they cover up? Why would they shatter Pink Diamond? Well, if we look at this size difference, and we look at the fact that she's a brat and she acts like a child, and we look at the fact she's messing things up, she's just has absolutely no self-control, and just the fact that she kind of gives the diamonds a bad reputation. If we know anything about Homeworld, they like to kind of skew things in their favor and sort of brainwash the other gems into wanting to do their bidding and really look up to them. I mean, we look at Peridot and her reaction on the moon. She was very much like, oh my god, Yellow Diamond is the most amazing, most objective gem. And we've seen that she's actually not that at all. She's pretty not objective. She has a lot of temper tantrums. She freaks out. She doesn't think things through all the time. So that's not the case, and they've just really built up to be these great and amazing beings, but they're not. Look at Pink Diamond's mural. She looks really elegant. She looks regal. She looks tall. I mean, she's up to scale with the other diamonds in this mural. Like, check it out. Like, look, she's like the same size, just about. Her hair is different. That may just been because she got poofed at some point, which is possible. Maybe she was just so small and so weak compared to the other diamonds. Maybe someone else poofed her. Something like that, I don't know, but she's the same size as them. And if you remember the reaction that the rubies had, and especially talking to Jasper here, if you remember this reaction, they were really kind of choked up about it. They were really heartbroken. She asked Jasper, it wasn't Jasper, it was Amethyst, but she asked Jasper, you know, what did you remember from it? And Amethyst didn't say anything because she was under the guise of Jasper, and she was like, yeah, I know, it really hit me hard too. And even just going back to Jasper's actual reaction, really shaken up by this whole thing. She was emotionally traumatized about the death of Pink Diamond, essentially. And I don't think any gems ever saw Pink Diamond, ever. Because if you look at that mural, someone would have definitely called that out. And I don't think the rubies would have been as hurt as they were. And Jasper even, Jasper's not that sensitive of a person, clearly, or as she is the most sensitive, but she has not shown any sensitivity up until this point. I don't think they would have had this reaction if they didn't really think Pink Diamond was this amazing, regal, great gem. And they kind of built it up to be like, oh my god, this is so tragic. It was so tragic. She was so young. It was just taken before her time. It wasn't time yet. It was just a tragic death all around. But she wasn't acting like that at all. She wasn't acting like that person. And a lot of us theorized that maybe Pink Diamond was like this great gem and she helped the rebellion and she loved Earth. But maybe she was the exact opposite. Maybe she actually just straight up was a bad person and no one ever met her because the diamonds were ashamed of her. So in comes the rebellion. And basically all it takes is, okay, let's frame Rose Quartz to shatter Pink Diamond. That'll get more troops on our side because they have this idea of Pink Diamond in their head that she's this amazing, young, great, up-and-coming diamond, and they'll just get rid of her. That'll bring more gems to our side, to the Homeworld side, to fight the rebellion, to fight the crystal gems on Earth, and also it'll kind of get Pink Diamond out of the way. She won't have to embarrass us. She won't have to completely make us look bad. Because Pink Diamond even says here that she's just as important as Yellow Diamond is. And Yellow Diamond says, why don't you act like it, son? You're not acting like you're as important. So I think Pink Diamond was very much in the way. Whatever reason, she was defective or whatever, she was too small. I mean, the size difference is insanity. Like, I mean, just, if I could find the frame, that's good. That's pretty good.
Like it's insane. It's just that size difference is crazy. She does not look like a diamond. She's about the size of Stefani, essentially. So long story short, I think it's very possible that the diamond set up Pink Diamond to be shattered by Rose Quartz, by the Rebellion, bring more troops to their side, bring more cause to fight the Rebellion, also get this defective, annoying, childish, bratish, overly small, probably weak diamond out of their hair, and they could just kind of kill two birds with one stone, or kill one gem with one stone, am I right? Okay. But yeah, I think that's about it. I think it's very possible that could be the case. What do you guys think of this? Do you think yellow or white diamond were involved in the shattering of Pink Diamond? Maybe it was just white diamond, maybe it was just yellow diamond, maybe blue diamond was involved, I doubt it, but who knows. Or do you think it was something else entirely? Let us know in the comments down below. Like I said, we have a ton of theories on Pink Diamond and how she was shattered. There's a lot of different options on how that could have gone down. So let us know what you think in the comments down below. If new here, be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and so you can be notified when we post more Steven stuff, because there's a lot of stuff to talk about. And if you enjoyed this video, and if you enjoyed this new format, be sure to leave it a like. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. I've been Michael Williams, you've been watching Cartoon Universe, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.